What's going on, guys? My name is Steve. Thank you for stopping by my channel. I'm just an American guy on a journey to discover my British and Irish ancestry. Today, we're going to be reacting to 10 weird facts about the UK. You know, I've definitely checked out some other videos in the past where I learned some interesting facts about the UK, but I don't know if I would say most of the facts I've learned so far in a lot of those videos were actually weird. I mean, some things were definitely weird, but I'm really interested to see if this video will actually tell me some actually really weird things about the UK. So anyways, guys, this is a fairly short video, so I'm not going to ramble too much. Let's go ahead and check out what these 10 weird facts about the UK are.
Weights and measures. Depending on where you grew up, in school you learned about either the imperial or metric form of measurement.
Sure.
While there's the occasional overlap in methods in our daily lives, in the UK, it appears that both methods are found literally everywhere. In the store, drinks on the same shelf can be found in pints and liters.
I've heard
Gasoline
that.
Gasoline is sold by the liter, but consumption of it is measured by the gallon. Food at the store, recipes for cooking, and measurements for various sports are all over the place. Word pronunciation.
Yeah, I've actually, a lot of people in the comments have actually mentioned that you know, the gallons, I believe your gallons are like 1.2 of our gallons in the US. And just there's so many different, interesting, weird measurement things going on. I think it would take me a bit of time to kind of learn how all the measurements are done. Or maybe I'm overthinking it and overanalyzing it. Maybe she is too here on this video. But I've actually heard that from a lot of British people that the measurement system is a little bit weird. So, yeah, word pronunciation.
Okay, it is true. Much of the world got its language from the British. That said, while we are sure they can make
much, yeah, like
certain words,
a whole
UK
lot of people
also has some pretty weird ways of saying everyday words. Name like Leicester and Worcestershire can cause tourist problems because they aren't pronounced anything like how they look.
Wait, hold on. No, I do get what she's saying here. How'd she pronounce this one?
Cause tourist problems because they aren't pronounced like Leicester and Worcester.
Leicester? Okay, if is that really how you pronounce that? Leicester. How would you guys pronounce this? I've seen this sauce, you know. I'm not going to say the words yet, but I've had people, when I said that sauce in another video, said I said it wrong. And maybe I do, but I've always just I can't even say it. Worcestershire. But Worcestershire is how it looks. Worcestershire. How is that? How does she say it?
Worcestershire can cause tourist problems because they don't pronounce anything like how they look. Hmm. Other words can be just as weird. For example, vitamins is pronounced vitamins. Privacy is pronounced.
Well, that makes sense. Vitamins. I can see why someone could. Vitamins. I mean, I can see it both ways. Vitamins, vitamins, you know, it's like tomato, tomato. You know, I think it's just the way you would say the I in this case, or with tomato, tomato, the A, how you pronounce it. You would say privacy. I would say privacy.
Privacy and garage is pronounced.
Yeah, I would say garage.
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 Ugh, Marmite. We couldn't have a discussion about the weird things of the UK without bringing up Marmite. This food is a dark paste made from yeast extract, which people either love or hate.
By the way, I've obviously heard of Marmite before. I definitely want to try it at some point. I'm a little bit nervous about it because I know it's a very, like, love-hate thing, like people say. It seems like half of the people out there love it, half the people hate it. I gotta admit, a paste made from yeast extract, when I hear that that's what it's made of, it doesn't sound too appetizing, but I don't know. Some people absolutely love it.
In the 19th century, versions of this bread can be found throughout the world, but the original can still be found in the UK, where people spread it on crackers and toast or even mix it with hot water. Most people
can't
get
hot
past
water?
The fact that it looks like brown glue and smells bad. There are even videos people have posted of friends challenging each other to eat this very British spread.
Wait, does it smell bad? I mean, it's a yeast extract, so I can understand. I would have thought it would have smelled kind of like bread dough or something, but I don't know.
Geordie Shore. If you ever thought the show Jersey Shore was weird, then you have to watch the British version, Geordie Shore. This program focuses on a group of people from the Newcastle area of Northern England with their very ridiculous storylines. Viewers spend most of the time watching the cast date each other, stab each other in the back, and make up only to repeat the process over and over. Awful fake tans, overly tight clothing, and questionable hairstyles prove that this has to be a classic Jersey Shore spinoff. We're just not sure if foreigners will be able to understand what the cast is actually saying, thanks to their thick Geordie accents.
So this is literally just like Jersey Shore. That's not something I watch. I've heard of Jersey Shore, but it's like I've heard it's over the top and it's just kind of like weird. I don't know. Has anybody actually watched this? Is it any good? I mean, what is it?
Accents. Since we're on the topic of Geordie accents, why not mention the fact that the UK is full of many weird sounding accents? It's like every region of the UK has a completely distinct accent.
No, I'm gonna stop you right there. You're absolutely right. I have learned that in the UK you have like a million different accents, and I now believe it. From when I first got started on this journey, people would say that you could literally travel like 2 miles down the road and you would come across the next town over having a completely different accent compared to the town you're from, and that's all over the place, and there's got to be tons of accents. But you know, like, there's a bunch of weird accents in America as well. I mean if you go to the Appalachia region, you'll definitely hear some weird accents. If you go down south, you know, we got quite a few different weird accents. But I will say, as a whole, I think that the UK has a much more diverse set of accents. And I'm sure because of that, there probably are more weird accents, because you just simply, I think you have more accents in general than the US. You know, I actually like a lot of the UK accents I've heard. I think a lot of them are very unique, you know. But yeah, anyway.
A confusing greeting. Around the world, there are a number of ways people greet one another. We're used to such greetings as hello or hi.
Sure.
In the UK, more than one foreigner has been thrown off when a local greets them saying, "You all right?" To a North American, when someone asks that, we immediately think that we either look sick or have been acting improperly.
Wait, people actually do that? Like, if you're going to say hello to someone, you say, "You all right?" To me, like, if someone, I now that I know that, probably is a thing, I wouldn't take it offensively, but like in a US, generally speaking, when someone says "you're all right," it's because, like, you know, they're like, yeah, they're acting like something's wrong with you. Like, you know, you're being a jerk or something, as they say, "you're all right, you're all right." You know, like you got an attitude. So they're saying, "you're all right." And, that's interesting. So that's good to know. That's something for me to keep in mind. Is that something that's really popular, that people in the UK generally will say "you all right" as a friendly hello? You know, it's just one of those things definitely would want to keep in mind, because otherwise, like I said, in the US, that would be, you know, you would kind of not necessarily take that offensively, but you would, it's like, it's almost like the person has got to like a little bit angry with you or something. It's hard to explain, but definitely different.
In fact, in the UK, "you all right" is just their way of asking, "how are you?" But it has no doubt led to some uncomfortable moments for both tourists and visitors. Strange.
Hey, that reminds me. In the US, we definitely will say, "hey, how are you?" Or, "how's it going?" "How's it going" is definitely something I would say hello to someone. "How's it going?" It doesn't necessarily mean I'm like wanting to hear all about their day necessarily. I could, but a lot of times that's just like, "hey, how's it going?" And you might just be walking past them, "hey, how's it going?" And that's just like a friendly hello. Do you guys do that in the UK as well? Or is that just kind of an American thing?
Strange laws. It's just common sense that when you travel to a foreign country, you learn their laws. Head to the UK and you are sure to find a few laws created many years ago that'll make you take notice. For instance, it's illegal to wear a suit of armor into the House of Parliament.
Yeah, I remember that.
Once
I heard that.
Inside Parliament, it's also illegal to die. If you're heading on down to the seaside, be sure not to harm any whales, dolphins.
Wait, it's illegal to die in the House of Parliament? What's the fine? If someone dies in the parliament, what fine do they get for? That's an interesting law.
Or sturgeon, as every one of those creatures within 3 miles of the shore belongs to the queen. two taps for water. When asked about what weird things stood out in the
UK, heard that.
Reddit users were very vocal about the fact that many places use two separate taps. Travelers note that one tap supplies boiling hot water while the other is ice cold.
I think that, you know, I've actually seen that before, right? Well, I've heard that. And, you know, at first it is a little bit odd because it's just something that literally I don't think I've ever seen that in the U.S. So it's something that we are not used to at all. And I remember talking, this has been months ago, but I remember talking about that in the comment section a little bit. And, you know, I think I understand that a lot of times, you know, because the U.K. is so much older, a lot of times the plumbing systems in the houses, because the houses a lot of times are older than a lot of the new subdivisions people live in here in the U.S. And so I think there's something to that, because I did hear that in newer properties in the U.K., that's not as much of a thing anymore. I don't know if that's really weird. It's more of just one of those things that's, you know, kind of different, but it's not really weird. You know what I mean? I get it. I get why that's probably the case, you know.
This can make washing your hands a bit challenging and
uncomfortable. That's true.
More than one traveler has complained about having to wash their hands in ice-cold water because there is no single faucet, as it is so common in North America.
That is interesting.
We figure the people of the UK either lack nerve endings in their hands or they are just a tougher breed of people. Drink.
Drinking age.
Drinking age. On the 16? Surface, the drinking laws in the UK sound fairly similar to those in North America. Across the Atlantic, the drinking age is 18. That sounds pretty good to a lot of the kids in North America. However,
18.
Go to a licensed establishment when you're 16 or 17, and you can also drink as long as
that's
you're
what I thought I was
adult,
like 16.
Your drink is served with your meal. In your own house or any other private establishment, the drinking age drops dramatically, and anyone over 5 years of age can legally drink alcohol.
What? I mean, I do believe that should probably be something that's left up to the parents anyway, but that's interesting. Like in America, you know what would happen if a parent got caught giving their kids, not even 5 year olds, let's say 10 year olds, alcohol, they might actually have their kids taken away from them, which is, I think, is, you know, a little over the top. It's one thing to like have your kids drinking and being drunk all the time, but it's another, you know, like, I know back in the day, my grandparents used to talk about how they would give a teething child a little bit of whiskey on the gums and stuff like that. You know, so sometimes, you know, there's reasons for a young child to potentially have some alcohol in certain settings, you know. I can't imagine a five-year-old actually sitting there and drinking till drunk. That would be very odd to me, but I don't think that's really what is going on there. But I do believe that in most cases, parents should be in control of what is happening with their children, generally speaking. So I think the government should be out of things like that in the first place. I don't particularly like government in everybody's business so much. You know, we have the government in people's business too much in America. I think you guys in the UK probably do in some cases. But anyway, let's continue.
Sandwiches. Who doesn't love sandwiches? Yes, it is generally agreed that we have the British to thank for our tasty creation, and specifically John Mentagu, the 4th Earl of Sandwich.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, adding their own weird twist to the sandwich, travelers to the UK may stumble across a sandwich known as the Chip Buddy.
I've heard
what
of that.
What is this? The Chip Buddy involves cramming French fries between two slices of bread and adding condiments of your choosing. Definitely not a low-carb option. The Chip Buddy is weird, but also sounds really delicious.
Guys, I gotta. Let me listen.
We hope you found some.
All right, guys, I gotta say, I don't think I would like that. The chip buddy, a chip sandwich, no, it's definitely not my thing. I don't like sandwiches that don't have meat in the sandwich. It's not to say that I've never done something without meat. I'm just not a fan of like that texture, like soft on soft. I guess meat can be soft, but I don't like. I don't want like a, for example, like a tuna salad sandwich or something like that. Like, I guess how to describe this, I like a sandwich to have a little bite. It's either got to have some crunch in there. It's got to have like some pull when you bite into a piece of bacon or another piece of meat. Just like I can imagine like a chip, like a fry with the bread would just be like, it's kind of like soft on soft. I wouldn't like that. I don't know. I mean, if you added some ketchup to it, I'm sure it would taste okay. I think it would just be the texture that would throw me off. But Overall, I knew quite a few of these, honestly. You know, a few of these were new, like the drinking age was definitely new to me, 5 years old. But definitely some reminders, like, I didn't know it was against the law to die in the House of Parliament. But there was a few more in here that are new to me, but I thought it was interesting. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Please click that like button. Feel free to drop your comments or suggestions about this video or others. And don't forget to subscribe to continue to follow me on my journey to discover my British and Irish ancestry. Until next time, guys, peace.